Hey, shout out to fucking Reapers because they did a fucking hell of a job yesterday getting fucking chased by BTR. Shout out to fucking first or two who fucking died. Here you go.
Wonderful shout out.
It's because we died yesterday.
Nah, first two fucking, they got their asses handed to them, but they managed to get everybody back home. So shout out to, I think O'Connor was fucking, after they got shot in the fucking throat, fucking managed to get everybody back home. So, so shout out to them. Attention.
Howdy.
Can you hear Major?
He's everybody hear me?
Can you hear him?
Yes, sir.
No. Yeah. Kind of.
Hey, turn Major up. Just turn him up in TeamSpeak.
So you might have to take a couple of steps forward.
I have him up
in TeamSpeak. I gotta find Bradley. I can't find his name.
Right back here.
Oh, okay.
Him and First Sergeant. Turn him and First Sergeant up.
I can take First Sergeant.
Yeah, I can too. I turned him up.
Really? Pokes me.
Hobart, no gun, no weapon. No gun, no backpack. Hobart, where you going? Hobart!
God, stop poking me.
Hobart.
Why is the AI touching my Hobart.
Yeah. Hobart,
drop your gun, drop your backpack, and get a permission.
Alright.
Yeah, that's it. You're running off from me, and I didn't know where you're going. No, keep the vest. No, no gun or backpack. We'll get this all after formation. Get in there.
Good.
Yeah, you're good. Get in there. Yep, you're good. Now get in formation. You're on the right. Alice, get your fucking ass over there.
Dude, my graphics are fucked up right now.
Company.
Stop you from moving over there.
Coon in cover. Well, pass it down.
Come on, Alice. Listen.
Yeah. Get up, you.
Thank you.
All right. How we doing, Orioles? Doesn't sound very motivated right now. How we doing, Orioles? That is still pissed for. How we doing, War Eagles?
Fucking amazing.
Yeah, a little better.
Decent.
Sound like I'm talking to the freaking schoolyard.
Dude, 20.
Is Boy Scouts? Or Girl Scouts.
Girl Scouts, sir.
It sounds like the Girl Scouts right now. I want You're damn right, Sergeant Johnson.
I just had some cookies.
We'll work on that. Alright. So, we hit April. As you've seen from our news flash, it is not true that we'll be picking up World of Warcraft, although I know many of you did support it. Outstanding. Outstanding job to our public affairs office, our Captain Cantu and his team, getting a little bit of fun out there on the front of our website. You know, you see lots of, you know, in the past we used to have lots of, you know, discharges or something like that pop up, and they're like, oh, just joking. Well, the joke's on them because I do process those. So, had that in the past, I'm pretty sure. Those that have been here a couple of years plus, remember some of those. It's a bad mistake on their part. But, luckily this year we didn't have any of those types of April Fool's jokes. Mostly just little ones. Some prior ones I recall. Let's see who had been here for them. I think maybe First Sergeant. With my uniform getting changed to a woman's uniform. That's been done. Thanks, CID, on that one.
Hey, don't blame us.
But there's a proper way and a good way to do April Fool's jokes that has funny written all over it, not disrespectful. So, you know, I'm pretty open. Obviously, that one I found pretty funny. They if Markel was still here, I think he was the one in CID that did it. Put little hearts and all that over them. So, other than that, as we move into April, you know, this will be kind of where we get in for Operation Bronze Fire. A lot of thick, you know, the thick combat. You know, as we continue to grow both platoons and grow this company, added Rhino Squad this last month, which is our mechanized with Bradley's to help assist in the heavy combat. You know, we're going in and kind of a little bit of uncharted territory. Many comments about, you know, how it's getting a little harder and harder, and it's only going to get harder as we move towards the capital city of Al Rayyak. You know, and that's going to be, you know, kind of where it gets hard. I mean, you're going to have fatalities. You're going to have a lot of KIAs possibly, pending how your spire team and how your squad leader react to the contacts. But rely on their leadership, rely on the things that they've been taught from their platoon staff and up with, you know, how to break contact, how to, you know, we went through all these battle drills, but we do have a lot of new privates and soldiers joining our unit that weren't here for our pre-mobilization training back in February. And to not have that, we really rely on those squad drills to fill in those gaps, to fill in those holes that, you know, these new soldiers. I mean, we've been doing this operation since February, so what's that, 3 months-ish? You know, I think we're on mission 12 or 13, so we've had a good amount of missions throughout. That's for both, that's the entire operation, Bravo Company and Alpha Company. But to, you know, these soldiers might not know everything that they need to, so fire team leaders, squad leaders, make sure your brand new soldiers are given a rundown of how to do a wedge, a column, you know, bounding overwatch, room clearing, stuff like that. That's where our squad leaders, fire team leaders, you need to focus on your squad drill training, you know, to kind of fill in those gaps, get them to understand. There's plenty of educational videos for our new soldiers to look at. They're in our warrior leadership course channel on TeamSpeak here. It'd be very good idea of you to kind of view those, get an understanding, and then take that to your fire team leader, take that to your squad leader, and let's put this into real world and, you know, do it in a squad drill or even just a practice. Doesn't matter. Doesn't need to be a squad drill. But a couple side notes. We have air assault. Our air assault school, the quarter is up, and we are having the sign up for next Saturday, April 9th. And we should be able to have a large attendance. I know we extended it out to a few realism units that we're sistered with, the 173rd, the 32nd Rangers. They each plan on having a group attend with us. But big kudos to, you know, First Sergeant for getting a course sign up and the cadre helping them run the course. Should be a good turnout overall. Airborne school, we have our monthly airborne school, obviously, with the 173rd. And with our own cadre, we're working on getting an airborne school EU friendly for us, and then we will also extend that out to the 173rd as they extended it out to us. To, you know, they have EU soldiers just as much as we do, and we got to accommodate for all branches, all time zones. So obviously it's not an easy task to do with having soldiers around the world. You know, we set the time and we kind of make it work the best we can. You know, sometimes us as individuals have to adjust our schedules a little bit. If you want to attend, by all means, sign up. You have to, you know, we set the times to be most broad with, you know, a good chunk of the unit. If you can't make those times, you know, try your best. If not, the school will be up again in another quarter for air assault and another, you know, every month for airborne. So, you know, just take it with a grain of salt and push on. Obviously, it's Sunday. Let's get our musters in. You know, last month, I think we were only sitting at 70-something percent. We're kind of declining. We used to be up in the 80s, almost touching 90 on our muster report.
Can you hear me?
I think out of 158 active duty, we only had 110, I want to say, at most, when I checked Saturday night, last night. You know, let's make sure that our squad leaders, fire team leaders, you're taking a look at that report on, you know, Tuesday, Wednesday. You know, you can click on who mustered in, you know, kind of control F, find your squad, see who hasn't mustered in on your team or your fire team or your squad, and start getting after them. I mean, we need accountability, as we don't push for, you know, 100% activity, but we do push for 100% accountability. We need to know our soldiers are paying attention, are mustering in, are showing up for squad drills, or TPRing. I mean, accountability is crucial to running a unit and keeping your squad active and your platoon's combat effective. So, armor clans, continue to vote there. That's a daily vote. Remember, it's not just once a week; it's daily. You know, you can. It's on our website. We do very well in being in the top, I'd say, 5 throughout the week. But again, I challenge everybody that there should be no reason that we're not number 1 Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. It's our most active times. A lot of our soldiers are on. You know, good job to our soldiers posting it in the shout box where we're ranked. Let's push a little harder. We can do it. And then there'll be those one-offs that, you know, a unit size of 20 has 600 votes in a day. I'm not sure how they're doing that, but, you know, as long as we're in that, I say, top 3, we're going to get that exposure. You know, we've already, you can look through our recruitment ads or our recruitment enlistment forms and see how many soldiers that we obtained through Armor Clans itself. It pays for itself. You know, it's a big PR push, and, you know, it really helps get our unit out there. By all means, it's not anything that's definitely not worth, I think we pay $20 a month. So that's not too bad. Facebook, PAO does an outstanding job on keeping our community page up to date. If you haven't already, get out there and like it. I think we're sitting just shy of 50. You know, not everybody wants to expose their personal life on Facebook, so it's understandable. But those that don't mind, by all means, get out there, like it. I mean, it's help promote the page. It'll be, you know, beneficial for all. Anniversaries. The month of April, we have only 2 anniversaries that are reaching their 1 year, effective on April 16th. Corporal Austin, who's our first platoon Widowmaker's platoon medic, he'll be reaching his 1 year anniversary with our unit. And then Corporal Glenn, as well, on April 12th, will be reaching his 1 year anniversary. He's a fire team leader currently right now, I believe, in first platoon, right?
Ghost, sir.
Who? So first platoon, second squad. Or third squad, second squad.
Yes, sir.
Second squad.
So big hua to these soldiers. Believe it or not, that is son and father. So they enlisted at the same time, and it's good that you see that they're still here playing together, and up same rank too. So they kind of had the same progression plan all the way up. But congrats to those two for hitting their 1 year mark. You know, 1 year is, you know, one of many, hopefully. For those that this is your first promotion ceremony, besides basic training, we do have quite a few soldiers that are being promoted to private first class, so this will be technically your first promotion ceremony, you know, unless you attended as a private trainee. Ideally, whenever your name is called, there'll be several names listed off. Make sure that you post correctly, you know, the one step back, identify your direct path, and, you know, get in front, send yourself on me as a file. And or as a line, technically, and then, you know, render a salute. I'll read off the commendation or promotion or whatnot. But usually we do this in chunks so that we can kind of speed along the process. Some people have told me that I'm a rambler and I talk a lot, so it's better to, you know, get you all in front at once. All right. Without further ado, I'd like to recognize and have Corrado, N. Lipnitz, Sanborn, Latanzio, Coffee, Heisenhower, Edge, Fisher, Rhodes, Clink Scales, and Nilsson Post. Some of those are Bravo Company. But...
Sanborn TP Yard.
Special Nice Ghost Printer.
Hasnar just crashed.
Alright, above face. Alright, these soldiers are hereby being recognized for being the newest grads out of our Warrior Leadership course, which was run in March by Staff Sergeant McGuffey. You know, for completion of this course, they will be hereby be awarded the NCO Development Ribbon, which will be placed only on their uniforms when they reach the rank of NCO. It is an NCO development ribbon for a reason. So once they, upon reaching the rank of corporal, that is when they'll be eligible to wear it. You know, these soldiers are kind of the future leaders, the ones that, you know, spent that, you know, this is not a required school, but it is a, you know, a leadership school that will progress your career here, meaning that you'll be eligible for future promotions to corporal, to sergeant, be able to get a squad, be able to get a fire team, you know, and it's all about, you know, kind of how to deal with the leadership role itself, how to deal with mediation and negotiations and stuff like that, defusing situations, you know, and every NCO needs to have this type of training to be a leader, as leaders, you know, tend to get hit with, you know, the petty stuff, the, you know, the quote unquote drama, the, you know, little things that irritates people and they have to speak out about it. Well, these NCOs and, you know, soldiers that go to WLC, they're given the fundamentals and the, you know, how to deal with this stuff so that they can deal with it at the lowest possible level. So as that's what our NCO and that's what our COC is for. So congratulations. Alright, fall back in. Alright, first up, Newsom, post, recruit tile. See here?
Doesn't look like it, so.
He's not here, sir.
Alright, recruit Newsom was put up. He has completed his 30-day probation, and hereby being promoted to private second class for completion of his 30-day 30-day probation for enlisting his DEP. Next up, go ahead. Let's see. Get me Charles Johnson, Sergeant Female Type. Hermanson Perez.
Hermanson TBR.
Steinberg, post.
Hermanson TBR, sir. Hermanson TBR, sir.
Copy.
Say it one more time. Make sure he really, really knows. Really, 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 really.
First up to you, Hermanson Tard.
Ah, thank you.
All right, Bellface. All right. These soldiers have been put up and approved for the Army Achievement Medal. You know, this medal is a medal that can be awarded for multiple things. Combat leadership, outstanding DMOS work, you know, working, you know, just being what we call a leader, you know, making sure that they are achieving everything, their soldiers are achieving everything. You know, this is kind of that milestone of getting the Army Achievement. It's no small task. I got some quotes coming out of our platoon reports and squad leader reports on some of these soldiers. You know, I'll read off Corporal Charles. Corporal Joseph Charles consistently helps his squad run, or squad leader runs second squad, second platoon roughnecks, taking action above and beyond the call of duty to help the element run smoothly. It is Corporal Charles who consistently hunts down AWOL soldiers to keep them in the unit. Corporal also takes the time out of his personal life to teach new soldiers the art of map navigation, small unit tactics, and anything else that may require in. Therefore, his useful advice and dependability makes him an invaluable asset to the squad leader. It is certain that second squad would be a lesser fighting force without him. That's a quote from, you know, his squad leader about why he's getting put up for an Army Achievement Medal. Sergeant Johnson. Sergeant Johnson has been an outstanding figure for her squad, recently being promoted to the squad leader position. She has hit the ground running as normal, corresponding with her duties in public affairs office and the podcast on a monthly basis, has not skipped a beat, and has produced outstanding and very entertaining podcasts. I got to agree with this one that, you know, Sergeant Johnson is really does care about the soldiers for her, and you could tell really cares about the entire unit as a whole.
You guys hear me?
You know, not just Alpha Company, mm-hmm. not just Arma.
You guys hear me?
Also caring about Bravo Company, getting out there, trying both games. I know we played last night a little bit. And it doesn't matter to her if she goes 0-16. You know, she's there for the you know, to kind of bridge that gap between between both companies, show that she's there as a DMOS side of things, PAO, and everything that she does there. Sarma Hermanson, obviously another outstanding squad leader. You know, I won't read his deck since he's not here. Perez, which is not here as well. Specialist Perez was recommended by his squad leader and obviously approved for being acting as a fire team leader. Corporal Steinberg. Corporal Steinberg is an outstanding...
I don't hear him, so if he calls my name, let me know.
Has an outstanding sense of dedication. He goes out of his way to assist his squad leader, train his fire team, and support platoon activity. I can expect that whenever I ask something of him, whether it's DMOS work, in which he excels, as seen by his work in the Rhinos logo and the FIG attendance, or squad work, to sum up, he deserves it yesterday and then some. You know, just an outstanding, again... Corporal Steinberg is a fire team leader inside his squad, and everything that he does, it's a, you know, kind of above and beyond. I mean, a lot of the things, if you notice all these, they listed kind of the going above and beyond outside their normal fire team squad leader duties, and they're here to care for their soldiers, and that's what a leader does. If you're ever in here just for a rank or just for a position, you're in it for the wrong reason. You're not going to be able to develop that leader below you because no one's going to want to follow you. Because you're just there to for yourself, you know, and that's not a leader. So, outstanding job to these soldiers in front of us for being awarded the Army Achievement Medal. Outstanding job. Right, Bellface. Congrats, soldiers. Fall again. All right, next up. Let's see. I might slaughter this way. Delarmy. Conley, Redman, Miller, Alexander, McDonald, Harrison, Gordon, Kusi, Stevens, and Brian. And Greenfeather. Post.
Major, you say Connolly?
Connolly, yes.
LOA.
Copy.
Want to back up? Oh, I can't get out. Okay.
Bellface? Hey, friend, stand by. We are taking contact. We have one hit. We're going to be providing medical now. Try to spin around, private.
I'm having key problems.
Got it.
Double tap on.
All right. These soldiers are hereby being promoted to the grade and rank of E3, Private First Class, for completion of 30 days time and grade. Recommended through their squad leader, approved through their platoon staff. As I said, many of these soldiers, this is their first time up here. User in the channel timed out. I mean, it's definitely that stepping stone. PFC is a rank that a lot of our soldiers, a lot of our soldiers in this unit can achieve quickly, whether it's completing basic training with honors, which some of our PFCs have done currently, getting Stripes Your Buddies, to where you recruit two fellow soldiers, they get through basic training, it's an automatic promotion. To PFC, you just got to really flag it and, you know, yell it up your COC so we can get it approved and, well, investigated and approved. You know, and just the overall manpower or soldier power, I should say, of our PFCs. I mean, they're one step away from the E4 Mafia. I mean, it's that position where you really dedicate whether or not this is the unit for you. Being in the unit 1, 2, possibly 3 months at this time. To achieve PFC, this is where you kind of get into that DMOS, figure out what you want to do in the unit on the admin side, whether it's FIG, helping training, PAO, helping our image of our unit, CID, making sure our professionalism, our uniforms and images are crisp, RRO, bringing in fellow soldiers just like yourself. I mean, there's a wide variety of things that you guys can jump into and take on. Each DMOS has an entry level, which is for PFCs or private first classes. So Congratulations, soldiers. Hua.
Hua.
Congrats, PSCs. Fall back in. Alright, next up. Let's see. Go ahead, get me Sergeant Jones. Post. Are you still having issues, John?
I'm in.
You're in? Post. You post in front of me.
You missed the mark.
Alright, Belface. Alright, Sergeant Jones, you are hereby being awarded the Army Commendation Medal, recommended through your platoon staff, approved through company command. I'll kind of just read the insert. Sergeant Jones stepped up as a platoon sergeant during Operation Bronze Fire, Mission Flicker, when Staff Sergeant Crashy had to disconnect due to a family emergency. Sergeant Jones, not given any notice that he'd be running a platoon, that he'd stepped up to the plate and started receiving and issuing commands up and down the chain without any backlash or fumbles in combat with 2nd Platoon Hellhounds. This is no small task to kind of just get thrown in your lap. I was there kind of right next to you a little bit and seeing how you handled the situation, and I got to say you did outstanding. There was, minor radio issues, but I mean, to get thrown in and not have any inkling, really, of how to, how to get a hold of somebody, or I know you were kind of stumbling in the very little beginning, but once you clicked, the platoon exceeded and you were able to issue commands and receive orders as well. So, outstanding job and congratulations. All right, Bellface. We'll have to get you up here a little bit more so you can post. All right, fall back in. Congrats. All right, next up, Latanzio Post. Or is he TPR'd? He TPR'd today, didn't he?
Yeah, he's TPR'd. He's on vacation.
All right. Warrant Officer Candidate Latanzio is hereby being awarded a Military Outstanding Volunteer Service Medal. For donating $50 or more in a calendar month to our unit in the month of March. This is a donation type medal to where, I mean, it's unit runs kind of on donations or i.e. Major's wallet. It's one of those that every penny is well spent. There's the donations that we receive from our soldiers is kind of the above and beyond, not required by any means. But we do want to show appreciation to even those that donate $5 or $10. So I'd like to shout out a special thank you to Warrant Officer Candidate Lee Conrado, and then Civilian Noble. I always it's for this for Noble. It's just insane. For anybody that don't know him, he's come out of our Bravo Company. He retired or not retired. He took a general discharge due to family issues. What would you say, Captain? Like 4 months ago, 5 months ago?
It's been quite a while.
And like clockwork, he donates about $25 a paycheck, or I think it's about a month. He pays $25 almost every month to this unit just to show his appreciation. He gets on and still plays with us when he can, but just the dedication to that soldier. If I could give out a civilian award or identify him in some way, get him up front. It was, if you see him, he goes by Noble, R. Noble, give him appreciation, tell him thank you, for everything that he does. I mean, this isn't, necessarily his unit anymore, but, he's still a part of our family. So, big hoo to the soldiers, a special thank you to those that donated, each of those that, got a special thanks, donated $25, and then, Latanzio donated $50. Actually, stand by, I quote that wrong, he donated $100. In the month of March, because he donated 50 in the beginning and 50 right at the end, and he really made that push. I remember seeing that in the shout box saying, "Hey, come on, guys, we're not hitting our goal." But outstanding job to him, and definitely thank Latanzio next time you see him. Because, yeah, that was $100 that he donated. Hua. I'll send it up. Alright, next up, give me Day, Bodwin, O'Connor, and Bloomingberg. Post. Bloomingberg, keep you on.
Yeah, I believe so, yes.
Outstanding. All right, these soldiers are hereby being awarded the Armed Forces Service Medal. The Armed Forces Service Medal is awarded to our soldiers that have been in a DMOS for 6 months or longer and have excelled in that DMOS, not just holding a slot that they don't do a damn thing, which we'll get to in a second. you know, for the work that they do, right now, Bodwin, Day, both staff sergeants, for the work they do in our Force Improvement Group basic training, and then as well for O'Connor, Sergeant O'Connor, and Corporal Bloomingberg, for the work that they've done in RRO in the past 6 months is just outstanding. I mean, both they very well need to work together. You know, for all the work that O'Connor and Bloomingberg do in RRO, if those soldiers aren't identified and bought through basic training and pushed and pushed to their limits and see what we can get and what type of quality soldier we have, that's what our FIG finds out. I mean, we're in a death spiral if we don't have that. An RRO that can bring personnel in, get them hooked, get them in here, show them what they want and what we provide, and then our FIG has to be there to prove it, back it up with actions. And I feel right now we do an outstanding job in both these DMOSs. So congratulations to these four soldiers for being awarded the Armed Forces Service Medal. Ooh. Bellface. Sergeant Day. Oh, lagged a little bit. All right, fall back in. Congrats.
Sir?
All right, next up. Two of them TPR'd, so Staff Sergeant Krasi, post. Beautiful posting. Alright. Bellface? Alright. The other two soldiers that TPR'd are Corporal Austin, Corporal Glenn. Both these soldiers, are all three of these soldiers, including Staff Sergeant here, are being awarded the Armed Forces Expeditionary Medal. This medal is awarded to our soldiers that have been on deployment status and training status for a year or more, meaning they have at least over 1 year time in service in their duties and have attended an operation, FTXs, multiple times. You know, congratulations. This is kind of more based on a time in service award, as if you're here for a year, good chances are you have attended an FTX, at least I hope. There's I don't know, a good chunk of them in a year. And obviously, operation, which we're currently in. So, congratulations and keep up the good work. Hua. Congrats, Staff Sergeant.
Thank you.
Hua.
Call back in. All right, go ahead. Get me Chamberlain, Breiner, Byren. Hardy, Barrett, Flint, Hugger, and Carr. Post.
Flint's got TPS up.
Copy. All right, center yourself on me. There you go. Alright. Bellface? Alright. These soldiers are hereby being promoted to the grade and rank of E4A, specialist. Recommended through their platoon staff and squad leaders. Well, and some of you are fire team leaders already, so outstanding. I mean, for one, to hold a fire team leader slot as a PFC, as we continue to develop and grow, I mean, it's going to be more common. You know, we need our leaders to be as high speed as many of you are, to enter to the rank of E4 Mafia or the E4 Specialist. You know, obviously you need to hold a DMOS. So that's one of the main requirements to achieve the rank of Specialist. It's kind of what holds people up, make sure that you're committed to both sides of the unit, the combat, which obviously everybody loves, and then the admin side or administrative side, which can have its pros and cons, I'll put. You know, everybody needs to be a part and, you know, show that dedication that many of you have, anybody over the rank of Specialist. If it's found that many of you that are Specialists or Corporals or even Sergeants or higher aren't holding a continuous DMOS slot actively, it could affect that promotion. It could affect even that rank you're currently in. We've knocked Specialists down to PFC for just not holding a DMOS. It's no different than a Corporal being knocked down to Specialist for not holding a fire team leader position or higher. I mean, as we grow, things will eventually change, as change is inevitable, and it's good. You know, as we continue to grow, we might not have enough DMOS slots, or there might be a DMOS that, you know, might not be all that appealing to some. Recruiting and retention might not be, you know, a shiny star as if you could be in FIG, but we only need so many range safety officers or drill sergeants. You know, so one of those DMOSs that kind of never close is RRO. We can always use more recruiters. We can always use more soldier development coordinators. Same thing with PAO and CID. I mean, these are some that really, you know, is there an end limit? I'd say in RRO and PAO, no. I mean, we can always use great journalism and obviously more recruiters, so. But congratulations to these brand new Specialists, and outstanding job. Congratulations, Specialists.
Thanks, sir.
All right, all back in. All right, this next one is the Good Conduct Medal. As I said, when they become large lists, I'm only going to call out the names. We do not have to post, being that this is just shy of, let's see, 20 to 25 soldiers. So I don't want the entire, you know, company to come forward. Good Conduct Medal is awarded out to soldiers for 3 months of continuous good service. It should be awarded every 3 months. If the soldier did not have a lapse of AWOL, meaning being placed on AWOL, you know, missing muster, you know, squad leaders, you know, that's kind of your duties to double check to make sure your soldiers muster in. If they don't muster for consecutive 2-3 weeks, something like that, it needs to be addressed. And obviously they need to be placed on AWOL. They may be active in TeamSpeak, but they're not paying attention to the website. And that's vital. But we got Lewis, Crashy, J. Johnson, Charles, Edge, Sanborn, Rhodes, Dinkins, Ta, Nelson, Hardy, Bodwin, Poland, Ugger, O'Connor, Cushy, Swanson, Netto, Alice, Green, W. Johnson, Chauvin, Latanzio, Fisher, LaFlash, and Gilmore. For continuous 3 months, good service. You know, big shout out to First Sergeant and myself. I didn't pay attention to us two. When I did this, I think the last time we were awarded a Good Conduct Medal was 2014. So we were always looking at, you know, we pay attention to our platoons and down and never really look at ourselves. Well, that was pointed out that was the last time we were. So we'll refresh that a little bit and give it out.
Yeah. We'll get it again in 2 years.
What's that?
We'll get it again in 2 years.
Exactly. But thanks for the soldier that kind of pointed that out and saying you guys are deserving just as us. That's obviously appreciated that soldiers are looking out for their command staff as well. So congratulations to these soldiers. I mean, 3 months, AKA or 2 years. We, you know, it's one of those that it's given out. So it's one of, you know, it's not a candy or, you know, I always say it should be given out just like candy. That's mostly for our fire team leaders, squad leaders, to start looking at our soldiers' personnel files. It says right there, time in service, or, you know, you can kind of take the last time they got it awarded and count up from there. They got it, last time we were awarded this was, you know, January, the soldiers that are being put up to it today. Well, it's April, that's 3 months later. You know, and if you don't recall any lapse in, you know, activity, meaning AWOLs, like I said, they need to get it. I mean, they deserve to get it. You know, soldiers can be awarded this up to 4 times a year if everything goes correctly. And they have no lapse of, and that shows that that leader above them is doing an outstanding job. You know, they are paying attention to the time and service, time and service, which means they're most likely paying attention to time and grade. Soldiers aren't getting passed up for promotion, for the administrative paper delay, as I've said in the past. I mean, just keep up doing what you're doing. Outstanding job. So, whoa. All right. Next up, Specialist Chamberlain, post. Buffface. All right, Chamberlain, you are hereby being awarded the Humanitarian Service Medal. I'll kind of read off the excerpt that was put in. PFC, now Specialist, Chamberlain has shown an outstanding potential and service into his DMOS and is always ready to lend a helping hand and teach something to anyone new. The soldier performs at the top of his tier in all functions of DMOS and combat-related functions and is an example that all members need to follow. You know, kind of the Humanitarian Service Medal is given out for that above and beyond those one-offs, we've given it out for soldiers paying, internet bills for a fellow soldier, sending them computer parts, paying for a headset, stuff like that. It's one of those that's not expected at all, but kind of goes back to the soldiers that really care about their team, really care. We've recently awarded it for those above and beyond, the call of duty, taking the extra time to teach, time out of your personal life, time out of your position in this unit, and it doesn't go unnoticed, and it just needs to, if you keep doing it, it's not a part of, you're gunning for a Humanitarian Service Medal, it's about who you are, and that will be identified and celebrated. So congratulations, Specialist. Cool. Congrats.
Thank you, sir.
Fall back in. All right, next
drop
up.
Drop your gun. Okay, drop your gun.
Go ahead, get me Day, Brownlee,
your mask.
J. Johnson,
drop
Steinberg,
your mask as well. Drop your mask.
Fear,
drop your mask.
Miller, Brian, and McDonald. Post.
All right, go form up. You're in the right. On the right, first line. On the right, first line. Over there.
Oh, I think we got everybody here almost. All right, a bell face. All right. These soldiers are hereby being awarded either their first or multiple airborne wings. These soldiers were the ones that attended our last month of March airborne school at the 173rd. Call out to Staff Sergeant Day, who was trained as a jump master during this qualification go-around. And then I want to say this is Miller's, Brian's, and McDonald's first. Fear, is this your first as well?
Second, Major.
Second? Cool. If this is your first jump, obviously, your uniform will be updated with, or you'll have to request it, but with an airborne wing. If this is your second or more, it's just noted in your service file so that we can keep track of how many times you've attended. Because the more you attend, you make your way up into being Jumpmaster certified, and then obviously getting that master and senior parachute badge as you continue to be trained and move up. So. Congratulations to these soldiers for jumping out of perfectly good airplanes. Perfectly good airplanes unless first starts flying, because then they clip trees. Oh!
It's sad because it's true.
Fall back in. All right, next up. Get me Delimore. Sorry, how do you say your name?
Delorme.
Delorme.
Delorme, sir.
Delorme. All right, Jones, C type, private type, Willie and Harrison, post. Alright, Balfaz. These soldiers are hereby being awarded their combat infantry badge stage 1. As we continue, as many of you know, and I've shouted out the last couple operations, how we changed the CIBs to be being awarded one stage per operation versus one stage per mission. As we continue to develop and push our activity and the way we do combat and operational statuses to be more involved, more upbeat, more operations and training. You know, we had to adjust and change. And, you know, so brand new soldiers coming in will be, you know, once they hit their first combat, fire team leaders, make sure you pay attention to that when doing your awards, that if they hit their first combat engagement with us, meaning it says, you know, Operation Bronze Fire, mission, whatever, and this is their first one and they don't have a CIB, you need to recommend them for a CIB stage 1. So congratulations to these four soldiers that I called out and soldier in front of me. And then outstanding job to the fire team leaders of these soldiers for recognizing that and squad leaders for recognizing that and you know, making sure that they get put up so that we don't have to backtrack medals once we complete an operation. So congratulations and congratulations. Follow me again. All right, next up, get me Nilsson, Hyverian, Perez, Ta, Sanborn, Rhodes, Edge, Poland, Clink Scales, and Dinkins. Post.
Dinkins, TP Yard.
Edge, TP Yard.
Dinkins, TP Yard.
Road, TP Yard.
Talk to the art. Oh, ball face. All right, these soldiers are hereby being promoted to the grade and rank of E4, Bravo, as corporal. They're entering the NCO Corps. You know, if they completed WLC, like I mentioned before, which I think Nilsson, you have. I know Klinkscale has. But these soldiers will now be able to actually wear their NCO development ribbon as they finally are now a junior grade NCO. It's kind of that first stepping stone. Each of these hold a fire team leader position. You know, I called out a good chunk of specialists, and that's outstanding that every single one of them should hold some type of leadership position, whether they are a fire team leader, potential squad leaders. You know, the extremely high speed soldiers that get squad leader as a specialist, that has happened and will continue to happen. As well as, you know, soldiers like Specialist Dinkins, which is a former NCO in this unit, who now finally just got back after retirement and is serving as the platoon medic of, Hellhound. So, outstanding job to these soldiers and keep pushing. You now are the backbone of this of our unit. As First Sergeant will contest that we rely on our NCO Corps to hold our customs courtesies, hold our, you know, our professionalism at bay, and make sure that we are the best. So that's our NCO Corps. That's what their duties are to do for us. So, congratulations and hello.
Hello.
Buffets. Congrats, NCOs. Fall back in. All right, next up, go ahead, get me Johnson, Sergeant, J-type, female type. I gotta always say that, because there's two Johnsons. Now there's like a ton of Johnsons. Charles and Chamberlain, post.
Yeah.
Alright, about face. Alright. Alright, these three soldiers in front of you have been recommended by their squad leader, platoon staff, and investigated and read over and approved through command staff to receive a Purple Heart. These soldiers, I kind of got a storyline and a backstory of each one of their Purple Hearts on how they achieved and were recommended. And then obviously the investigation is put forth and talked to, and you know, if any demo rec or videotape can provide proof as well, obviously it's a done deal. But I'll start off with Sergeant Johnson. In regards to the event that occurred on 6 March 2016 during Operation Bronzefire Mission Sea Doom, where Sergeant Johnson and my team were ambushed midway through the city by insurgents. We were able to locate at a, or we were located at a cafe building at an unknown, or an unknowingly had an IED located on the roadway just to the north side of the building that detonated and came down on top of us. Sergeant Johnson provided accurate security for Reaper 1 during this event in question, which maintained a control and maintained and controlled lead over all of her fire team elements. She was wounded and resuscitated, or revived, and successfully completed the mission. If anyone in my squad deserves a Purple Heart, it is definitely her. We got Corporal Charles. Corporal Joseph Charles assumed command of Roughneck Squad after the squad leader was KIA during Operation Bronzefire Mission Sea Doom, and led the men, or his men, effectively until he was incapacitated by enemy fire while crossing a street with his fire team. His unconscious body was carried to a collection casualty point, a CCP, by Private Matthew Miller, where the private administrated CPR until reinforcements arrived to revive the wounds of the wounded corporal. As Sergeant Hermison, as Sergeant Hermison reassumed command, Corporal Charles resumed command of his fire team and led them without falling again throughout the duration of the mission. You know, again, it's outstanding to see that, you know, the stepping up, the taking the blunt, you know, leading from the front, and yeah, I mean, they're going to happen. PFC Chamberlain, now Specialist Chamberlain, assigned as a fire team leader in 2nd Platoon, 1st Squad Reapers, was incapacitated during Operation Bronze Fire Mission Sea Doom. While getting treated in a house, the fire team was ambushed and an IED went off outside during damaging the building. PFC Chamberlain was later treated by the platoon medic Specialist Dinkins and reassumed command of his fire team as fire team leader for the duration of the mission. If you look at all these, I mean, each one, you know, it's kind of one of those given. The Purple Heart is no easy task. There was multiple Purple Hearts that were put in, and we really had to investigate the backstory. You know, some key things for a Purple Heart that need to be in a leadership position, or just an outstanding, like they better have a very good backstory to kind of back up a Purple Heart. It's no small task to get one. You know, it's not as easy as just getting shot, you know, knocked out and brought back. You know, that's not a qualification for a Purple Heart. I'd give a marksmanship badge to the enemy, is what I do there, because obviously you were exposed, you know. You know, one of the things that a Purple Heart relies on is that leadership, that they showed an effective kind of downdraw of when a squad leader or a fire team leader goes down, I mean, and their team reacts and able to get them back up. It's not just, oh, we're going to wait and, you know, they'll respond and we'll get them back in reinforcement style. It's all about the leadership. And obviously second is, you know, that they actually took a bullet in the arse or something like that. It's one of those that, yeah, you know, that's based around the leadership. So, you know, squad leaders, fire team leaders, keep that into account when recommending. I mean, I think we had, this is three that were approved. I want to say of about nine, that were recommended. Not saying those soldiers, those other six, didn't deserve it. It's more or less just, you know, again, going back into the backstory and figuring out how or why or what they had to do to achieve that success in that. So congratulations and outstanding job to these three soldiers. Ooh.
Ooh.
All right, Bellface. Congrats for getting shot. Cool.
Still hurts.
Fall back in. Alright, next up. Go ahead, get me Sergeant Worrell, Staff Sergeant Day, post.
Day.
He dropped connection.
Never mind.
Ballface. Sergeant Day, when you can post.
I do apologize, my TTP just died.
Yep, figured. Alright. Ballface, there you go. So, without further ado, a couple changes coming. As we are with the retirement of Mr. Maz. As the first platoon leader, we had to take a month or two here to really look at and evaluate our squad leaders, anybody kind of over that E5 mark of what we need to achieve and move forward. Because a leader retires or a leader gets discharged or anything like that, you know, the key thing that I pride ourselves on, and you should all as well, is that we have a humongous development plan for a lot of our soldiers. You know, obviously, we use, you know, we identify fire team leaders out of potential. You know, it's all based on potential, what they can be, as they have not held a leadership position prior. We need to be able to select those fire team leaders, and that's kind of the make or break. Outstanding fire team leaders obviously move up when a slot's available and become a outstanding squad leader, as Sergeant Worrell has shown. Developing several other great fire team leaders. It's outstanding that he is proud that several of the squad leaders that are current have come through his squad, as well as, you know, just his potential leadership that he provides. And kind of that next step, as you go up, obviously positions, you know, if everybody wants to be Major LaFlash here, trust me, we got just shy of 200-some people in the unit. Only one of you can be the replacement when I retire. Now, if you imagine that as you kind of go up, fire team leaders, we can have, you know, there's two or three fire teams per squad, four squads per platoon, and so forth, per company, and so forth. So, as you can see, there's lots of leadership positions that are could or will be available. But as you move up, it really becomes the best of the best that gets us thrive. We move to the method of really selecting the best for the job, the best for the duty or the position that they're being selected for versus the person that's been here the longest or the person that has, you know, it's their turn because they, you know, they're next in line, you know, via time in service or something like that. And we've gone to selecting, you know, the one that we know are going to thrive and hold the position and proudly do it. And we're not going to have issues, you know, a month down the road when they get bored of it. So without further ado, I'd like to hereby promote Sergeant Worrell to the grade and rank of E6, Staff Sergeant. Oh. Alright. I would also hereby like to congratulate him on being selected as the first platoon sergeant of Widowmakers. Staff Sergeant Worrell has shown an outstanding sense of leadership throughout being a squad leader, throughout being the NCYC of FIG. Just the passion that he puts into training and developing and, I mean, getting you know, AIT off the ground and everything from there. Just an outstanding NCO. So very big congratulations for being named the first platoon sergeant. As you mentioned, or may have noticed, we have another platoon sergeant up here, the exiting Staff Sergeant Day. Staff Sergeant Day has been selected and kind of been groomed over the last, I'd say, 6 months or so to take a commission. You know, one thing that we've been working on is, you know, his accountability, his leadership, And it has definitely strived. He's the one that keeps Widowmakers top notch and really pushing. So I'm proud to promote Staff Sergeant Date into the Officer Candidate School, OCS. He will be taking on schooling over the next month or two as a cadet while leading in the position of First Platoon Leader of Widowmakers. As we, you know, want to continue to develop and push, I think these soldiers are in the right positions for what their ability is. It is definitely, I look forward to seeing the Widowmakers thrive and really push. So congratulations to Cadet Day and Staff Sergeant World. All right. Buffface. Congratulations. We got Team Hua here.
Thanks, sir.
All right, fall back in. Did we lose Rhino too? Negative, we're still here. Over. All right. And lastly, Corporal Steinberg post.
That's a negative. I'm losing Rhino too.
Yeah, I saw the wreck. I wanted to make sure.
Do we want a second? Bellface? All right. With the exiting Staff Sergeant Whirl from Scorpions, you know, recommended through, obviously, Sergeant Whirl himself, you know, high regards from Cadet Day, we have selected Corporal Steinberg as the replacement and will be put into the slot of squad leader of Scorpions. It takes a long history of what the Scorpions have done under the command of Sergeant Whirl. And knowing that you've come up under Staff Sergeant Worrell and what you provide as a fire team leader, I know without doubt you'll be able to take it and take the Scorpions to the next level of activity, next level of skill, combat, and really strive. So congratulations. Without further ado, I'd also like to hereby promote you to the grade and rank of E5 Sergeant. For your completion of time and grade as a fire team leader. So keep up the good work and you know, make sure you keep Staff Sergeant World proud. Bellface. Congrats, Steinberg.
Thank you, sir.
Fall back in. Alright, stand by. Let me check notes here quick, make sure I didn't forget anything. All right, so that kind of concludes our ceremony today. 7 minutes over, dang. I blame First Sergeant. He had his little talk with you guys in the beginning, so.
My 2 minute talk.
All right, I just want to give a quick shout out. Last night we had a very large basic training class of 16-38. Outstanding job to FIG, class of 38. I mean, that shows that's 38 basic trainings that were run since the 1st of January. Just outstanding job. We're going to be hitting triple digits, I guarantee it, whenever we get through the fiscal year of 2016. But just a quick shout out to new soldiers, Private Second Class Hammonds, right? Private Tompkins, who passed, Private Second Class. Private Lunk, who graduated honor. Is that how you say his last name?
Yes, sir.
All right, well, McGarrett graduated private second class. Lopez graduated private second class. And Mills graduated private second class. So outstanding job to these three soldiers. We did have some requalifications, but they, you know, to go through and knock out the first stage of basic training. I know some of those just enlisted this week and already are through basic training. So, I mean, that's key. That's leadership right there. You know, showing the soldiers that, you know, they are active. Their fire team leaders are after them. Get them signed up for basic training. Somebody's holding the hand of a brand new trainee so that they didn't get lost. You got to think about these brand new soldiers. They don't know what to do. You know, some of them have joined realism units in the prior and have past experience, but we don't do it a lot like what others do. I mean, I personally have never been in a different realism unit the way we do things. I mean, it's been 10 years. But, you know, it's one of those that you that are coming from different realism units, we may have similarities, but there's things that we do that a lot of these other units do. That's why you're here. You know, we inspire you. You guys show interest in what we do, and you strive to be the best. So, you know, outstanding job. Make sure all fire team leaders, it doesn't even need to be fire team leader, battle buddies, other privates, private second classes, private first classes. If you see a brand new soldier coming into your squad, kind of get in contact with them. I mean, it definitely will help the retention aspect of things. You don't know how frustrating it is to coordinate, you know, all the labor that goes into recruiting a soldier, to processing that soldier, to you know, doing orientation for this fire team leader to meet and greet, get that soldier through basic training, and then find out they discharge because they have no guidance. You know, that's very frustrating. And make sure that as a soldier, if you have anybody new that comes into your unit, private, a recruit, make contact with them, add them on Steam. You know, every soldier is responsible for retention. I mean, that was kind of our, as I mentioned in our January newsletter, retention is our goal of 2016. You know, we recruit like no other. I mean, RRO does an outstanding job. Our PAO advertising does an outstanding job. But when we can't retain, it's pointless. Why are we recruiting? Why are we, you know, wasting our soldiers' time? You know, and it's on our soldiers that are here today, all 54 of you that are in this channel, to, you know, find those soldiers and talk to them, get them to feel part of the team, know that they're not alone, ask their questions to you, stuff like that. You know, if I could tell you, some of you that are PFCs or corporals or sergeants even now, I guarantee would have liked that when you first enlisted. I know I would have when I enlisted back in 2006. I would have loved to have that type of guidance so that someone's there to not hold my hand and babysit me, but direct, you know, show me the way, show me what's next for me, show me how I can get promoted to private second class, teach me how I can get PFC right out of basic training. You know, if our fire team leaders and fellow battle buddies and stuff like that took me to the range and, you know, showed me how to qualify, what I'm aiming at, how to shoot a silhouette target at 300 yards, stuff like that. You know, we can make our soldiers better by investing in each other, making sure that our soldiers are high speed, that the person next to me, I trust 100%, because why I was there from him in the beginning, he's going to be there for me in the end. So make sure you take that back to soldiers that aren't here. Squad leaders, fire team leaders, really push that in your squads. You know, retention is key, and it starts all the way from that brand new soldier, the time that we need to invest in them. So I believe we can do it. I know you guys can do it. This NCO Corps is an outstanding, outstanding force, and this unit's an outstanding force. So other than that, that's all I have to kind of wrap up with today. We have our operation in T-minus...
45 minutes, sir.
47 minutes. 48, whatever. 47 minutes, and so obviously we launch from here. Today's op-ords will be kind of covered, if not already, by your platoon staff. You know, we got Cadet Day and Lieutenant Lewis leading a charge. You know, last night and yesterday we had some Fragos to patrol outside our FOB here, try to get a gauge of what the enemy force is going to look like, you know, it's definitely not easy. I know, I want to say 2nd Platoon launched in the afternoon, correct? Hellhounds launched in the afternoon, had a pretty eventful push out and patrol, took some contact, got rammed by a BMP, I hear. So
no, that was Reapers.
That was Reapers?
Yeah, so, Reapers got fucking chased by some cats.
I can report that we got no injured and no KIA, so that's good.
Outstanding, shush. That's leadership right there. I know I was present for when Widowmaker stepped off last night, and I gotta say, watch yourselves, soldiers. Lots of suicide bombers. You know, there's, you know, potential for, you know, anti-aircraft man pads out there. So if you locate one of those, by all means, let's get it called out. Right now, if I recall, first platoon will be heading out at 1500 into the city for, you know, clearing some villages, providing local aid. Don't forget medical kits or medical crates and whatnot. Second platoon Hellhounds will be kind of taking overwatch and pushing along the western flank? No, the northern flank of the cities. To provide aid and overwatch for first platoon. So brawlers will be on standby, as with the anti-aircraft, medevac will be grounded unless very well needed. Same with the rest of brawlers, will be grounded unless very well needed. For sure, we need to make sure that we can't lose any more aircraft, people. We need, as ground infantry, to do our best to protect our assets. If we can't get our brawlers off the ground, it's going to be a bad day for us. You know, if we don't have air superiority, there it is. Mm-hmm. It's going to be no easy task to clear our cities, clear these villages, provide aid to a local. Make sure that we PID targets. As I mentioned with the suicide bombers, we can't really do much about them. Sorry. we really can't do much about suicide bombers, but we got to trust that not everybody is. You know, they'll hopefully we can weed out where that IED factory is. But other than that, first art post.
channel.
Okay, we'll connect now. Going off comms. Roughnecks is down below. How copy over?
Garrett's got eyes on an RPG tube sitting on top of a building, but it's not moving.
RPG Barrett, is not moving.
Check it out.
Diablo, say again. Roughnecks is doubly. How copy over?
Forever Kid reporting out.
User disconnected from your channel.
We got contacts northeast in town. Sit rep on that explosion. This is Diablo. We saw a friendly running through the market and I think he's in Adams now. Yeah, we got friendlies.
Reaper Actual, this is Reaper One. That was probably Rough X.
Guys,
Deblo's providing Overwatch.
Irony, Mr.
Confirm that Roughnecks found the next.
Talking shit about me, he's the last. I'm medic.
Go.
Talking shit. Talk shit, get hit.
Yeah. Is that rocket?
Out the building.
Yeah.
Contact, that's.
Sarge, that was an enemy RPG that was inbound this direction. Perez took care of it. Who do you got there? Oh man.
I don't know if they're touching your guys from the last option.
He's still working
he's
on
okay.
me.
He's staying.
Can we get sit rep? Make sure everyone's up.
He's only stabilized. Just
check it, guys. Make sure everybody's up. Reapers, did you guys go to secure that first IED explosion over?
Barrett and Perez, pull back to the edge of the mosque.
Okay, Chamberlain, you're back in action.
Roger. Otherwise, Dublo's holding on one of the easternmost buildings over.
Irony in this. I fuck.
Hellhound, Diablo over. Go for Hellhound. Are the buildings to Diablo's north being cleared over?
Roger that. Applying tourniquet on right leg.
This is Roughneck Actual taking over for Roughneck 1. It's Roughneck
and
Actual.
Right, hand.
Sergeant Jones is back.
All call signs, all call signs. We've got friendlies coming in from the east. Confirm east.
What's your prompt?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was from the east.
Requesting permission to leave.
Roger that, we've got eyes on them.
User disconnected from your channel.
Quick bots are great.
heads up.